So we were talking about those dry terraces, and if you look in the cut bank, you can see that they're made of these rocky gravels where the water passes through very quickly. It's where we have our submesic spruce stands. Now we've simply come across the road, maybe 15 feet, and we're looking at this stand, which we're calling spruce sedge. And what's happening here is a completely different ecological process is happening here. What's happening here is in the spring, you have frozen soil right to the surface. And as you look up the slope, you can see that the water is going to come down from the high elevation through here, and it's going to spread out. So as that active layer melts, the water, the ice that was in the soil turns to water and runs over the active layer that's there. It's continually sending moisture down to these slopes here. So the vegetation tells us what is happening. If you pan down here, we're looking at these sedges. This is Carex scirpoides that is coming down here. It tells us this particular plant, we know, grows in continuously moist and sub-irrigated soils. So there's lines of evidence, all these different lines of evidence we use to interpret the site and the process. So if you're going to have more rain in this environment, if you're going to have, if the permafrost table is going to go deeper with thawing, the processes on this site will change. And by understanding that, we can possibly understand or predict how this site will change. The grizzly bears like these sedges early in the spring. They're nice and tender. They'll come and have a chew on them. But if they stop growing here, it might lose its value as grizzly habitat.
32, sample 3.
So N equals 32.